How's everyone doing? Today I'll be doing a video on some unseen horror movies that I have in my collection. I've got eight different titles right there. Don't want to spoil it by showing you the spines right there with the title. But these are movies I've had in my collection, some for a while and some I just got recently. And I plan on watching them all within the next couple weeks. And once I do watch them, I'll be doing another video talking about them more in depth and possibly standalone reviews for them, if I feel very strongly one way or the other towards them. But hopefully this could give you some recommendations as well if you think the synopsis sounds intriguing, or the characters, or just the theme overall. And hopefully it'll end up turning out good for me too, by the end when I watch them. Let's go ahead and get into them, and let me know if you've seen any of these ones and what you think of them, and which one of these sounds the most interesting to you, and which one you think I should watch first. And also, give me some other horror movie recommendations for me to check out that you think I haven't seen yet. Leave me those comments down below. But let's get into it. First up is a newer release, Annabelle Comes Home. I actually really like the first one. A lot of people seem to like the second one more. The second one was a step down for me. I didn't like pretty much anything about it. It was a little bit too more reliant on jump scares. I didn't like the setting with all the kids, the orphans. And just the orphanage in general. I like some of the cast, the older cast members. And there was like one really cool, creepy scene towards the end. Besides that, it was mostly jump scares. It had some good atmosphere, but I thought it was a big step down from the first one. I liked it a lot. And I feel like I'm in the minority in that one. This one right here looks to be Annabelle with a babysitter twist going on. I guess a babysitter is watching a little girl, and somebody goes into the room with all the different, haunted and cursed relics, and I guess lets Annabelle out. That's pretty much the gist that I got from it right there. So I will be watching this one shortly. Next up is The Lingering. This is a Chinese horror movie, and the synopsis is very short right there on the back. It says Dawa and his mother spend a terrifying night alone in the basement after being tormented by a strange and dangerous presence. Years after his mother's death, Dawa is forced to return again, facing the presence that once tortured him as a child. It sounds like it's going to be a malevolent spirit. I don't know if it's a ghost or demon kind of thing. On the back, it does look like it's going to be decently creepy and some good atmosphere, perhaps. So gonna check that one out. I'm always looking for good Asian horror movies. I feel like for a good period of time, they were just amazing and just killing it horror-wise. Next up is The Believers. I remember seeing clips for this one, but never seeing it in its entirety. This is directed by John Schlesinger, who did Midnight Cowboy and Marathon Man. And I really like the cast in here, too. You've got Robert Loggia, and you also have Helen Shaver, and I know there was a couple other people. Martin Sheen, that was one of the big names in here that I remember being up for a draw. So basically, it's about this Caribbean cult. Ritualistic child murder is going on, and I guess his son is particularly vulnerable, and there's some ties to, I guess, some kind of corporations or something like that. Another interesting thing that really stood out for me about this one too is it's shot by Robbie Mueller, who is the cinematographer partner of Wim Wenders, Lars von Trier, and Jim Jarmusch. So those are amazing directors right there, and the cinematographer is as well. And that is just a big selling point. So it looks like it's going to be creepy, and I like when they do with like these kind of like voodoo and Caribbean cults and stuff like that. So it sounds intriguing, and I like the cast. I like pretty much everybody involved, the cast, the director, the cinematographer. Jimmy Smits is in here too. I knew there was like a lot of recognizable people in here. So I'm excited for this one. And this is a Twilight Time release. It's limited to 3,000 copies. I remember getting this, I think, on one of their sales. I try to watch out for a lot of their sales because over a period of time, if they still have stock, they do some really good discounted prices, and I like the releases a lot. Next up from Severin is Absurd. And, let me before I get into this one, The Lingering is from Wellgo USA, and then Annabelle Comes Home is a Warner Brothers release. And next up is Absurd. This is from Joe D'Amato, and this is, I guess, his follow-up to Anthropophagus, which is just absurd in itself. And this one looks to be very similar. George Eastman, who's a screenwriter, he plays the Greek boogeyman, and I guess here he goes into suburban America, and I guess it's just going to be crazy and ridiculous. It says on the back, incredibly sadistic, gruesome as hell, all these kind of blurbs hyping it up. It looks like it's going to be bloody, lots of guts piling out, and I wonder how this is going to work, because in the first one, Anthropophagus, he looks like he's dying at the end. So, spoiler, it's a crazy movie though. You can kind of, yeah, right there, and you see like the guts and stuff. So I don't really know how that's going to play into this one. Is this a prequel or is this actually a direct follow-up? Somehow he survives it. I mean, for all these different horror movies, you kind of have to suspend disbelief, and they can always survive. I mean, how many times has all the horror icons been killed and brought back to life? So I'm definitely looking forward to checking this one. The first one was crazy and ridiculous and gory. I actually really enjoyed the heck out of it. It is a nasty, gritty, entertaining one. I will say it does have some dramatic pacing at times, which I think could take some people out of it, but I thought it was fine. It worked well for it. But yeah, it's a saga of doomed nurses, butchered babysitters, and biochemical clergy in some of the most insane splatter scenes in Italian gorehound history. Sign me up right there. I'm sold. So apparently, this was the first time it's ever been released, at least on Blu-ray. I'm sure about DVD, but it says on the back, you can throw out your bootlegs now. And yeah, this is, like it says, it's borrowing heavily from Halloween, I guess, because it's in suburban America, and I guess there's maybe a hospital setting. It says nurses, so and again, butchered babysitter. So I think all of it sounds pretty amazing to me. And again, I like the first one, and you kind of know what to expect with Joe D'Amato. So looking forward to checking this one out. This one is from Cult Epics, Death Laid an Egg. This sounds bizarre and crazy and ridiculous. This is limited to 300 copies. I had no idea this was so limited. It's the Blu-ray, DVD, and CD edition. It says it's the arguably the most insane, idiosyncratic giallo ever directed. This is from 1968. Some of the stuff just sounds so, it's kind of compares it to Godard's Weekend in terms of its crass car crash fetishism and savage anti-bourgeois sentiments and overall anarchic spirit. So got a whole bunch of different crazy things. It's set largely in a high-tech automated poultry factory that breeds mutant boneless chickens. That right there is just so intriguing, kind of like a Poltergeist-esque reminds me of, but I am sure it's more to it than that. It's just a socio-political sophisticated avant-garde giallo. It says it's more pertinent today than it was when it was first released. So it says again, it's deals with the battle of sexes and the perils of technology. And this has the original Italian superbly edited giallo version and presented in high definition with new bonus features. So yeah, this is it sounds nuts. It sounds like there's going to be somebody who they don't, it kind of gives you some mystery and intrigue about this man, married man who may or may not be a serial killer, and then his wife who's domineering. It's a Swedish bombshell actress in here, and murders double crossing mistress. So again, it sounds like a crazy giallo, and I'm looking forward to that one too. Again, I think the thing that I thought really kind of drew myself to this one is the set largely in a high-tech automated poultry factory that breeds mutant boneless chickens. That is very relevant for today's for all that kind of stuff going on. Next up, another one from Cult Epics is Angst. This is what I remember seeing a clip from it, and it was graphic and violent and crazy, and I was like, I need to see that at some point. And finally, I am able to. Another release from Cult Epics. They've done some really good kind of sleazy exploitation cult crazy stuff. So I'm always looking forward to seeing what they release. And this one has a nice slipcover for it too. And there's a crazy looking scene right here. This is a German film from 1983, only 87 minutes, and it's a photographed by legendary Oscar award-winning Polish animated experimentalist Zbigniew Rybicki. I'm sure I messed that up. And I like how this put how they put this one too. And it's scored by Krautrock synth god Klaus Schulze from Tangerine Dream. Krautrock. I'd never heard that term before. I actually lived in Germany for 4.5 years as a kid in Frankfurt. But I guess I was young at the time, so I didn't really experience like Oktoberfest and a lot of like crazy horror movies like this. But I remember certain things that are so vastly different from here in the US to over there. But yeah, this one sounds like it's going to be just sleazy and rampant with lots of blood. It says it's a forgotten classic on the fringes of the slasher cycle. And there's a a crazed killer who's, it was based on the real life serial murderer Werner Kinskic. I'm not familiar. It's basically him just stalking through Viennese countryside, and yeah, just the music and the cinematography style and just being so violent and crazy kind of led itself to the notoriety. Again, this is based on a true story, and it says we guarantee you, you'll never ever forget this one. I remember just seeing that one clip and it always being on my mind, so I definitely believe that. And the rarest masterpiece of cinema, says Gaspar Noé. I know Gaspar Noé, he said that he's watched this more than 40 times. There's a blurb on here on the back. So, again, sleazy, bloody, that's what I'm expecting right there. And it looks like it's going to be some great score and cinematography, too. Next up is The 27 Club. This releases from MVD Visual. It looks kind of creepy, and right away, this was kind of like a impulse. I was like, I need to check that out. Great cover art can definitely draw me in sometimes, especially when I was a kid. I grew up in the VHS era, mom and pop video rental stores. Seeing all the horror VHS artwork really enthralled me and got me kind of into it. And yeah, I just always think about that. I love that a lot of these companies are now doing like the VHS retro slip covers and just kind of the throwback artwork style too. But basically, it says on the back, another really short synopsis one. Singer-songwriter chasing fame and a journalism student researching his thesis are drawn into a sinister underworld as each attempts to discover the truth behind the 27 Club. So maybe some kind of underground, weird torture porn club. I'm not really sure, but that's kind of what it looks like right there. And same artwork for that. But I'm excited to check this one out. And this includes a CD soundtrack from great music in here. Todd Rundgren, Trent Reznor, Atticus Ross, a whole bunch of other people too. So the soundtrack's got me intrigued, and it does look kind of creepy and bizarre. I like creepy and bizarre for horror. Next up is one where I heard this title, I was like, I don't know about this, but it got me intrigued because the writer and director is Rock, Paper, Scissors, and it's written from the writer of Friday the 13th, Victor Miller, and it's directed by Tom Holland, who directed Fright Night, Child's Play, done a lot of great things. And this right here on the back did look creepy. It stars Michael Madsen, who I guess is a detective, and it's based on a story of someone who's released from a mental hospital. He's a serial killer who may or may not have been cured, and basically he's haunted by memories of childhood abuse and murder victims while being menaced by the cop who put him away, Michael Madsen. His only friend is a pretty neighbor, Monica, who says she wants to interview him for a book, but does she have a more sinister motive in mind? Dun, dun, dun. Of course she does, right? I like the people involved with the film, the writer, the director. I like Michael Madsen, too, even though he's done some stinkers, paycheck movies. I don't blame him, you know? Got to survive out there, but again, it does look creepy. The title, though, is like, come on, they're really running out of ideas here, you know? Truth or dare, hide-and-go-seek kind of themes, rock, paper, scissors, like the boogeyman, like you can't say the name. Like, so many things have, like, children's games and just ridiculous things have just been made into horror movies now, and it's getting kind of silly with some of the titles and ideas. Rock, paper, scissors, I think, is a terrible name. I don't know how it's going to play out. I think of it and I just think that's ridiculous. Oh, Ari Lemon from the original Friday the 13th is in here too, and Tatum O'Neill. I kind of missed that on the back. They didn't really, the only one that's really noted on the back is Michael Madsen. So that's intriguing too. He was the original Jason right there, little kid Jason. But yeah, so again, the people involved with it have me intrigued, and it does look a little creepy. So there we go. The title, I don't know how. It doesn't sound like they're going to do anything with the game. That's what I was thinking initially. But I don't know. They could play something weird with it. We'll see. So there you go. Those are the eight unseen horror movies, all Blu-rays and then one DVD down there. So if you've seen these movies, definitely let me know what you think of them. Let me know which one of these is your favorite if you've seen them, or the majority of them, or all of them. And let me know which one of these sounds the most intriguing or interesting to you, and which one I should watch first. And let me know if you have any horror recommendations for me to check out, movies you think I might not have seen. Leave me those comments down below. And again, once I do view them coming up in the next couple of weeks, I'll talk about them more in depth coming up in a future video, and possibly standalone reviews for them too. So look forward to that. And thank you so much for the support on here. I really do appreciate it, and hope everybody's doing well. Take care.